Have you ever wanted a place where you can store all the information that you need for your interior design business as an accessible hub? Well, over the last few weeks, I've been building a hub just to do just that. We have created an HQ, keeping all our contacts from suppliers to clients. We have set up portals for communication of images and ideas between the designer and clients. We've got a place to keep our SOPs. We're able to manage our projects and keep control of all our tasks related to all our businesses. Phew, we've been busy. And the best thing about it is we built it from scratch. So we have an intimate knowledge of how it has been structured and created, and you can adjust it to fit your business like a glove. Hi there. If we haven't met before, my name is Joanne from Design Inc. Co., where I help interior designers start up and scale up their interior design businesses. So this kind of strategic, techie, info-based content is of interest to you. Subscribe. I have plenty more coming. So back to the Notion dashboard. In this video, I'm on the downward stretch. I'm going to be building out our materials, fixtures, and fittings library, as well as heading back into our operations tab to take a look at setting up our branding guide that we can use for both internal and external use. Let's jump in. Here we are in our Notion dashboard, and you can see as we scroll through, we've built quite a bit. We've done our tasks. We've got our HQ here, which we've split into projects, operations, people, and growth. We are going to head back into this final section, this interior design materials, fittings, and fixtures. What we're going to do is we're going to build that and then connect it to our projects and also to our individual project portals. So we have a gallery view, and this view is split into two different types of views. So the gallery view and a sample table view. So this is to actually see the materials that we have uploaded. It's very image based. It's easy for you to see, and we can actually create different views and split them into the type of materials. But let's just hop in and have a look at one of the cards. So this is the basic build. We create a gallery view, and then we're going to create a template for each of these. We have a created timestamp here. We just use a date property. You can see there's a created time, and you can change in the type of time that you would like. And we have a type, and I have split the type into FF&Es and materials. Now you could even add more types. You could have this split into different types of materials, or we could then add material fabric, we could have material timber, whatever you like. And likewise with the FFE, so we could do FFE bathroom, we could have FFE, whoops, kitchen, FFE laundry, whatever you would like. And I've left this as a multi-select. If you had a sink that could be used in both a laundry and a kitchen, you could actually choose both. So here we have our contacts. First thing that you probably would want to do when setting up our materials is actually set up it as a supplier. We'll head back into our supplier, our contacts database, into the supplier view, and pop that in as a supplier. We want the lead time. So this is just a note of what we have. Now I've just put in a short lead time, long lead type, or whether it is kept in stock. And you can again just work out which time actually suits you. You might want it months. Here we're going to sort of add in our project galleries and add that in. And we've got a couple of different project galleries that we want to do. It just depends on what we want to call this. We can actually just rename this, and we can just call it project gallery client. And then we have the kinds of rooms that we have. Let's just edit the property. I've set that up as a multi-select. I've just listed out a whole heap of rooms. Then whether we've collected a sample. Now, if we've got a sample, then this is what this sample table is for. So check that on. That means that we've actually got a sample of the material. You can mark your sample with a code. So for example, I could add a property is sample code. And that might just tell us where that sample is kept, whatever you would like to do with that sample. I find that very helpful, particularly if we're lending out samples and I've got to make sure that I replace things and so on. We have a URL which takes us straight to the website. And in the use, again, I've added that in to what we actually would do with that sample, whether it's a floor or wall. It's just more information. You can add any properties that you like, and I actually encourage you to do so. The more you add in, the more powerful this becomes, because you can organize it in many different ways. I've also created a template. You could have an image here, so I would actually add in that you would add the image here, and then you might write some notes about the material, then any care documentation, if there's PDFs that the supplier has given you, and you can write any other notes and supply details and the price. I would probably put a date there as well so that I know when you've collected it. So you can tell how old that sample is, whether it's been around a long time, and make sure that it gets updated regularly in terms of price and availability. Let's just create one. So I have just started creating this floor tile. If we go into our main database, we probably want to head into our suppliers view and make sure that we add in this wood floor. So this comes from a supplier called Tongue and Groove. And then we can add it again as another supplier. So we can have Tongue and Groove. We can actually add in a lot of detail here. Let's go in here and we can add in our phone number, the project gallery that it belongs to. You can link it to multiple pages if you've used it in different projects. And again, we can add in our contact details. So this is a material that I want, which is this floor. It's already been connected in the supplier database, and we have just marked a few things here. We've connected it to a project. It's a short lead time. If we've got an order or if it's been ordered, we can tick that there, and we can actually put in a code and a sample code and then the URL. So if we go back into Chrome and we find the actual page, so let's just go back and find the range, and I want to find the color. Here we can copy the image address, and then we can go back into Notion and pop the image in. I'm just going to paste in the image address. We've got the image there, and we can write any notes that we have on the material. You go into that site, there's a PDF download. I might want to add that in and write any notes that I have about it. Once that is set up, we've got a fair bit of information here. We can say it is for the floor. So let's go to material. So I'll be more specific, engineered floorboard. There we go. And then we have that. Now, if you want, you can then keep on doing this. And it's probably better to be doing this bit by bit. And Notion's a really great place to keep that kind of content. Head into the second part of our tutorial. And we are going to set up a branding guide. So I've created a page which actually sets out a little bit about our branding and our strategy. We want to have sort of an overall guide for our staff and for any external people to be able to understand how we use our colors, our fonts, and make sure that our brand is adhered to currently. If you have an external social media manager, you might want to give them a copy of this branding guide so that they understand where the colors are coming from, what fonts you're using, and any brand goals that you have. So here you can actually write a little bit of a blurb and document your branding guide and strategy. And we state that we have a consistent look and feel. And if you have any rules of usage, this is where we'll add it here. We then have a screenshot of our colors. So you could use something like Coolors. If you use Squarespace, I tend to have a screenshot of the Squarespace site. I also have a Canva board. So let me just show you that. And if you do want a copy of that, I'll leave a link in the description and you can download the board where you can actually save your colors as a brand guide and then upload it here. Let me just show you. If we go back into Chrome, and we have, this is the brand template that I've created. So you can pop in your logo, your submark, your favicon, and then you can link your palette. And I've kept it to 5 colors because I tend to work with websites and we usually have a black and a white. And then this tends to be the accent color. This is a neutral color and this is a darker neutral color. But you can then add in your colors here and then your fonts in here. This is used for Squarespace. In Squarespace, they have this kind of color scheme. You can actually print this off and use it as a good reference. When you're designing your Squarespace site, you know exactly what colors you are going to have to use. So let's just head back to our Notion template. And you can see here, I also have uploaded a gallery, and this is just a very small inline database. And all it is, it's an image of the color. So just take a screenshot, pop it in there, and you've got a link. You can go in and add in the hex code here, and you always have a reference. So I would put a whole list of colors here. Then here is where we can add a little bit more about our brand mission statement and so on. We've got our spaces to write our values. We've got, you could also have your vision here. So we could add in a vision. Let me just change that. And whoops, I think that's a heading 2. And let's just underline it. There we have. So we can actually write in our vision here. So let me just copy this and okay, brand vision. And then we get into our fonts. And again, I take screenshots of logos. And then here you can link your logo folders. So if you have certain folders in Dropbox or whatever, you can link them there. And again, this is a very easy way of sharing the page with someone externally. And you just have all that information there that you don't have to actually send an email at all. This documentation there. I've left a link for Google Fonts. There's also, you can also, if you have used Adobe Fonts, you might want to paste a link here and then just add a few screenshots of your font families. Probably be a good idea to name them and explain a little bit about how they're used. So here we have, for example, heading 1, 2, 3, 4. However you would like to use your fonts, make sure that you have a little bit of a copy of them here. So you could just actually upload an image and then you can explain the weight and the size and you can put all the rules that you would like to do. And again, this is just a really quick reference when you are trying to work on your site or in social media. So you might also want to explain if you're using a handwritten font, why you've, and you might have a link to the license, whatever you have. And finally, I added a section, which is your brand voice. And again, this is an inline database. And sometimes we come across words that we like to use in our brand. For example, there might be catchphrases that you use. So I have just created a database where you can store those things. So I like to keep something where if I've got screenshots, if there's witticisms that I use, if there are little catchphrases that you use, they're things that you always say. It's good to start compiling those because when you're writing out your website pages, when you're writing out your emails, you want your emails, your words to actually be consistent so people can recognize that it's you speaking to them. And this is where we can create it. In the next video, which is our final video, we're going to tidy up a few things. We're going to finish looking at our database, making sure that we have connected all our databases together. If you've signed up for a copy of the Notion dashboard, you can expect it in your inbox shortly. And I hope that you have enjoyed this series and found it useful. And please leave me any comments if you would like me to expand on any area. See you in the next video.